Hello everyone, this is Vishwanath Chavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now I am here to explain the pipeline schedule optimization concept. So at the end of this session, the students will be able to illustrate the state diagram for a given function. So before focusing on pipeline schedule optimization, we should know the term greedy cycle and MAL, minimum average latency. So the greedy cycle is nothing but whose edges are all made with minimum latencies from their respective starting states, which is called greedy cycle. And the MAL, which is nothing but minimum average latency, which is at least one of the greedy cycles, which leads to the minimal average latency. So bounds on the MAL. The MAL lower bounded by maximum number of check marks in any row of reservation table. And this is lower than or equal to the average latency of any greedy cycle in the state diagram. The average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of ones in the initial collision vector plus 1. So this is also an upper bound on the MAL. Now we'll see the term delay insertion. So this is the delay insertion, which is introduced based on the requirement. For example, the purpose of delay insertion is to modify the reservation table which yielding a new collision vector, and this leads to a modified state diagram, obviously, because once we get new collision vector, so there will be modification in state diagram, which may be produce greedy cycles meeting the lower bound on the MAL. So this is the main objective to insert the delay. So we'll see how delay can be inserted. Before that, now this is the three-stage pipeline, which is having stages S1, S2 and S3, which is made up of three types of connections: feed forward, feedback, and streamline connection. So here we are getting the output, which is output X, which is delivered from function from stage S1. So this is the reservation table and the operations which are being delayed. Say along x-axis, it indicates time slots T1 to T5, and along y-axis it indicates the different stages, stage S1, S2, S3, like that. And here X1, which is connected to next stage S2, S2 to S3, next in T5 it is connected to S1. Now it is delayed by one clock cycle, and this is delayed by one clock cycle D1, this is D2. So this is a new state transition diagram with the minimal average latency, which is equal to 3. So this is the initial collision vector 1011. So the third position is having 0, and hence we will receive the same state after third three times right shift to this, and perform logical OR between this initial collision vector and the value which we received after 3-bit right shift. That gives the same value, and hence it is indicated to the same state with 3-star. And after fifth onwards, all 0 will be there. If you are with this initial collision vector, you will get same state. And this is having the minimal average latency which is equal to 3. So this is nothing but at least one of the greedy cycles which leads to the MAL. And the greedy cycle is nothing but whose edges are made with minimum latencies from their respective starting state, which is 3. And hence the MAL is 3 for this new transition diagram. Now this is the insertion of two non-compute delay stages, which is D1 and D2. So here the stage S1, S2 and S3 are there, and these delays are going to introduce the new state. So we'll focus on the next state transition diagram, which is drawn by considering the delay. So before that, your answer for this question: what are the bounds determined by Shire on MAL, the name of the scientist? So what are the bounds? So pause this video and write your answer. I hope you answered for this. The answer is, the MAL is lower bounded by the maximum number of check marks in any row of the reservation table, and it is lower than or equal to the average latency of any greedy cycles in the state diagram. And the third point, the average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of ones in the initial collision vector plus 1. This is also the upper bound on the MAL. Now this is the modified reservation table by considering the delay. Now D1 and D2, they are introduced here. So here we are having different stages S1, S2, S3, and D1 and D2 delay are introduced. And hence this is the new reservation table we form based on the introduction of delay, as we saw it in previous diagram. Here. So this delay is going to lead the new collision vector. See here, this is the modified state diagram by considering the introduction of delay. So this is the initial collision vector 100010, and based on this initial collision vector, normally wherever we find 0, that particular position indicates that which is permissible, and wherever we find 1, that indicates that there is a collision. Now we have to avoid the collision. So by based on the logic which we studied in previous video, based on that, now we are going to find the next states. So if you right shift this initial collision vector, then we'll get 0. Rightmost position is 0, means after right shifting one bit position itself, we get the permissible. So and hence the next state, which is 110011, so which is received by ORing the right shifted value with initial collision vector, and hence this one is indicated here. Similarly, after right shifting next 3, 4, 5, we will come back to this state 3. This is for 4, this is for 5, then 6, 7th. This is for 7 onwards. So these are the ways with respect to this state. So 7 plus onwards, you will get all zeros, and hence you will get you will arrive to same stage. So if you consider this state 1 2 3 4 3 and 4, they are the outlets. So 3 which leads to next state, this one, 4, which will come to this state. And if you consider this state, then 3, 4, 5 will be permissible, 3, then this is 5, this is 4, and 7 onwards it will come here, and 5 will come back. If you take this state, then this is 1, then 4, 5, this is 1, this is 4, and this is 5. And after 7th, we will come back to the same state. So this is how this diagram, the new diagram is formed, which is by introducing the delay. So based on that, if you observe this diagram, the MAL, minimal average latency, that will be 1 plus 3 divided by 2. So here the minimum value 1 and 3, 1 plus 3 divided by 2, which is equal to 2. And hence the modified state diagram gives the MAL is equal to 2. So if you observe this MAL with respect to the previous MAL, so previous was 3, now this is 2. So this indicates that there is a optimization in MAL. So this is how the pipeline is scheduled for optimization by inserting delay. So these are the references. Thank you.